I have learned that understanding the basic aspects of neuroscience has a direct impact on improving the capabilities of leaders to lead effectively, since knowledge of neuroscience and its impact on emotional intelligence makes leaders more aware about themselves and help them understand why they behave as they do. We as leaders must understand that our default behavior is a result of how our brain was developed to survive in the Stone Age and how it must adapt to the modern world for us to be a successful leader. The good news is that we can reconfigure our brains proactively and have more control over our behaviors. Neuroscience provides us with useful information towards building a total picture about how people can raise their awareness, learn more effectively, behave more appropriately, and hence be higher performers and better leaders. It is strange to accept that the brains of babies born into today's world are so similar to those delivered during the Stone Age. This, however, is true. However, the beauty of this Stone Age brain of ours is that many of the neural connections get reconfigured dependent on the environment. The reason we cannot merely survive but also prosper in today's world is that our brain is able to change how it operates, either reactively or proactively. That certain parts of our brain are reconfigurable is good news. This neuroplasticity, as it is often termed, is reactive to the environment and circumstances we live in. We can use this learning to be proactive in developing our conscious behavior and thought management. We must consciously and proactively enable the reconfiguration of our brain in ways so that we become the leader and person we want to become. The brain is enormously costly to the rest of the body, since it can demand up to 20% of the body's energy, more than any other organ, despite making up only 2% of the human body by weight. We all know how we start to lose concentration after a short time when we are told to do something, when we are told what to do and are not motivated by it. No one asked my view. We lose concentration and motivation after a short time. Energy gets depleted and we are unable to focus on the task at hand. On the other hand, working things out for ourselves or having insights also uses high levels of energy. But the difference here is that adrenaline-like chemicals are released that sustain the energy levels. These activities feel more positive and are more likely to be sustained and successful. The importance of neuroscience is that it provides us with the information to enable us to improve our personal performance and leadership skills. A few of the things leaders need to do differently in light of the implications of this is, as the essence of leadership is change, it is important that the leader understands the why and how of neuroplasticity and uses this approach for personal change as well as for enabling the change of others. Leaders telling people what to do does not provide sustainable, effective change. Leaders must support individuals and provide them with the right environment to reach their own solutions through insights. To learn new behaviors, leaders must provide the opportunity and environment for their people to focus on and spend the necessary time learning them in order to sustain change.